explain what encouraged you to do the Gorilla Glue Challenge.
Well, it really wasn't a challenge. I actually started it. I really didn't think, did you see what the young lady tried with the Gorilla Glue with her hair?
Uh-huh.
And I was like, okay. And I thought, I thought she was just playing around, because I didn't think it was that serious, that Gorilla Glue would actually do all of that, you know? I actually tried it a couple of times before. It never really worked for me for anything, like doing it actually on things. And that's what kind of, I was like, okay, well, she's blind, and, you know, all these challenges going on. So I said, I'm going to go ahead and try it, you know?
All right.
And it went backwards, you know?
I got you. So walk me through the steps of what you did. Tell me what you do in the video with the cup and the glue.
Well, basically what I was doing was I was trying to show people that it wasn't as serious as she was making it to be, you know? So basically what I did was I trimmed the cup with some Gorilla Glue and placed it in my mouth for a few seconds, for a few minutes, in which I thought that I could lick it off, kind of, you know, to moisten it and pull it right off, but that didn't work, though.
So talk about the experience when you went to the hospital. How long were you there, and what treatment did you receive there?
I was there for maybe about a little over an hour, 2 hours or so. Basically, I had my pressure was up. I mean, I was going through a lot of distress also. And they did like a peeling, basically a moistening peeling, you know, to get it off of that. From my upper skin on my lip, you know. So basically, all that has been torn off, you know.
And what is the recovery process?
Basically, keep it covered up. You don't want, you know, with all these things floating around and stuff like that, you don't want to get it infected. You don't want anything like that to happen, you know. Keep it covered up with all these viruses going on and stuff like that. And you know, I have medication I rub on it to keep it, you know. And hopefully it just heals up. It doesn't get infected or anything like that.
Did they give you like a time frame for how long you have to keep it moisturized, keep it covered up?
Yeah, 2 to 3 weeks. And once it starts to dry, I'm going to take it off and let some air breathe, you know, let it catch air, you know. But right now, I really need to keep it covered, you know.
Right. So when we researched your name, we saw that you're on Dr. Oz in regards of the ice cream challenge. And then from looking on your Facebook page, we do see that you're a rapper. And many insinuate that you're doing these challenges to seek attention, to boost a rap career, or even just to go viral. So what are your thoughts on that?
Well, I would never want to stick no Gorilla Glue to my lip and have it stuck there and have to go through all the situations I went through. Basically, I was trying to start. Of course, everybody knows social media runs things right now. Everybody's on social media. It gets a lot of attention, and that's what's going on. I mean, there's a lot of different challenges. So I wouldn't say that I'm doing it to boost my career, because people start a new challenge every day, you know? They start the mom challenge, the brother challenge. So what? If that's the case, why are those people doing it, you know? I mean, actually, it's just a part of social media, but I didn't think it was going to go this far, you know? But if it helps, it helps, and if it doesn't, it doesn't, but that's not what I did it for. I don't want to be sitting up here like this. I mean, you got Valentine's Day coming up, I can't even kiss my old lady, you know? That's not what I'm trying to do.
So what is your message to people watching this right now who are seeing these challenges? What is your overall message to them?
Well, see, well, the thing is, I don't want to send out a bad message. The same thing with the ice cream situation, which was completely blown out of proportion, but I don't want nobody to try, especially these kids, you know? They look at stuff on the internet, and they be like, okay, they'll try it. Now, if somebody kid going to do this, this could be worse, you know? Somebody could die, anything could happen. So this is definitely one not to try. Let's just stop this now. It's over with for that. Let's act like it never started, you know? It's very harmful, and it could harm a lot of people, you know?
Well, that's all the questions I have. I wish you a speedy recovery, and thank you for your time.
All right. Thank you, too. Y'all take care.
You too. Thanks.